I think it's a typically Australian trait, but for all of Keith Urban's phenomenal worldwide success, he remains delightfully unassuming and unaffected. What you see really is what you get. And what you get is a hard-working superstar who hasn't forgotten that Keith from Caboolture is just as important as Keith from Nashville. But these days, the singer also has other roles. Keith the husband and Keith the dad guarantee he's equally happy and busy. In a year defined by Zoom meetings, closed borders and hard lockdowns, it's somewhat surprising and a little strange to be face-to-face with the superstar I'm about to interview.
Peter.
Keith.
How are you, mate?
Good to see you.
It's been a minute.
We can't even shake hands.
No, it's very 2020, isn't it?
While Keith Urban is one of the biggest music acts on the planet...
I feel a bit nervous doing this.
Do you?
Sitting in front of someone I've got to know a little bit.
It's good I'm not alone.
No, it's good. Oh, good. So
he's also just an ordinary Aussie bloke who I haven't caught up with since the world turned upside down.
I've been on the road for 60 for ages. So I do the news every night now.
Yeah.
I've done that for the
last... I watch.
You watch?
Of course.
Geez, you're a good man.
Of course.
Get that for the promo.
Just like all of us, singer-songwriter Keith Urban and his family, actress-wife Nicole Kidman and their daughters, 12-year-old Sunday Rose and 9-year-old Faith Margaret, have spent the better part of this year locked down together at home in Nashville. Looking at this photo, oh, I remember someone. COVID-19 literally stopped the kid from Caboolture in his tracks. No longer on a tour bus and forced to finish writing and recording his latest album, ironically named The Speed of Now, in isolation.
How hard was it for you, Keith, when we did just come to an abrupt stop?
I was making my record and I was going to different studios. We had residency in Vegas, so we were, you know, everything's buzzing around, it's all going well. And then suddenly it's like, OK, everything's grinding down, stay here, can't travel, this is it, can't go to studios, all the gigs are cancelled. And I'm like, what the... no. And I have a studio at the house, but I wasn't jumping down into there and getting back to work. I just want to put my trackies on and sit on the couch with the family and watch TV and wait for the whole thing to blow over.
So, what have you been up to?
What have I been up to?
So how did you get off the couch?
I called a mate of mine, an older guy who I sort of get advice from, is much wiser than I am. And I was on the phone with him. He pauses at 1 minute, he goes, mate, we've been on the phone 10 minutes or more, and all I've heard is what you can't do. Tell me one thing you can do. Oh, well, geez. Well, I could get in my studio tomorrow. I could call an engineer, a friend of mine, to come over and we could do some work in the studio tomorrow. Great, when are you going to do that? Oh, well, I'll call him right after I get this phone. And everything just sort of off it went.
So many people are trying to figure out a new way to do their job.
Yeah.
And that'll give them some comfort that even Keith Urban or others struggled to figure out how to navigate this.
Well, negativity is... it's got no limits or boundaries.
It can be paralysing.
Doesn't care who it affects. Yeah, it affects everyone. I am who I am, I
just miss who I was when we... Keith ventured past the living room and down into his studio to not only finish the album, but pick up the guitar again for his fans. He kicked off a series of virtual performances on his YouTube channel.
How many guitars have you got?
A few, Mark, is that right?
A far cry from the global stadiums he's used to selling out since moving to Nashville from Australia 27 years ago.
Bet you can't wait to play all these tracks in front of 30,000 people.
Oh, my gosh, so looking forward to playing live, particularly this album. This album's built to play live. Someone said to me, what's it like, you know, playing in front of a camera? You finish a song and there's just no reaction. Just dead silence. I said, it reminds me of every night I played the clubs growing up. Got years of experience. Who knew that those club days were going to come back into play for me?
But the yearning to play live, to play for a packed audience, evolved into something special for Keith. Genius, in fact, at the height of the pandemic. While most gigs for everyone had been cancelled for 2020, he put on a drive-in concert in Tennessee for local health workers.
It was very apparent, this we're not going to be playing for a long time. And Nick walked out one morning and she goes, what about a drive-in? It's fantastic. It's a great idea. Playing to people in cars. This might be the way to do it, you know? You've got this massive screen behind you, pre-built. Who knew that drive-ins were still happening?
Mm-hmm.
we put a stage at the base of it. All the cars are assembled. Everyone's facing the right direction. This might work.
Thank you so much, and God bless the drive-ins. Come on!
And was it fantastic?
It was really fun, yeah. I mean, it was strange, and playing to all these people who I thought were going to be in the cars, but that were actually more on their cars.
They broke protocol, right?
Near their cars.
Yeah. But did you also get that wonderful feeling? These are heroes. These are great people.
Yeah.
I'm making them smile, and they're going back to intensive care units or whatever.
Yeah. My whole album's dedicated to them too, because it's 2020 is all about this one thing that we're dealing with all over the planet, and what they're doing day and night, 24/7, and their families too. Mm. They forget about. What their families are going through for them as well.
A pool table. Is this part of the urban relaxing way of life?
We've got one at home. I love playing. I'm not very good at it, but...
Oh, that makes two of us.
Last time I interviewed Keith, 13 years ago, aside from playing a pretty questionable game of pool...
Thank you. You've set me right up.
We were both newly married and had hopes of becoming fathers.
Did you see?
No, I didn't see anything.
Since then, those dreams have come true. We're both proud dads of two young girls.
I don't think I've ever loved in such a pure way.
Mm.
The purity of the love I feel for my kids. I love my wife, I love my mum and dad.
Mm.
But the purity of the love for the two little girls helped me evolve.
Oh, gosh, yeah. Every day, always. I mean, it started with Nick. I mean, that was the first time when I just went, this is not about me, this is someone else, you know? And then that widened out and got deeper and just expansive when the girls came along. I've never loved like I love Nick.
Yeah, right.
And then the girls, another level again. Then God
whispered your name. You and Nicole are a great love story. And you've always said that she's had a huge influence in your creativity.
Oh, gosh. Yeah, life changing. Life beginning. This is very different, you know. I had no comprehension of it. Changed everything.
In pandemic life, was it, you know, you've suddenly brought together the wheels of the truck stopped turning for you two. Did Keith have to help with the maths lesson or the English lesson?
Oof, not the math lesson. Yeah, wouldn't don't get dad to do that. I left school at 15, so I'm glad there's smarter people helping our kids right now. It's amazing. We're a really tight family anyway, you know, and it's the way Nick was raised and very much the way I was raised too, but tight families, you know, you have breakfast together, you have dinner together, we go everywhere together.
Everywhere, which included relocating back to Australia in the middle of lockdown for Nicole to begin work on her latest multi-million dollar production, Nine Perfect Strangers. Currently filming in Byron Bay, this is the second book by Australian author Leanne Moriarty that Nicole has introduced to Hollywood.
And Keith Urban, when my cheek is against yours, everything melts away, and that is love. I love you so much. God bless you. Thank you.
Big Little Lies, Celeste, an extraordinary performance and an extraordinary role and an incredible focus on domestic violence. I've always wondered how you felt when you watched those scenes of your wife.
It's hard to tell your soul that she's an actor and she's acting. My soul is alerted to this this fear and you're like, it's okay, mate, it's okay. Just calm down, she's just acting.
It was very heavy to watch.
Because she's so bloody good that it's... The first time, I remember the first time I was on a set with her not long after we got married, and she had to do this guttural scream because she'd sort of discovered something terrible. And I was like nowhere near the set, and I heard her scream. My whole body just freaked. I went, oh, bloody hell, she's acting.
Would you ever like to act?
No. Yeah. I love making records. I love being in the studio. I think as much as she loves being on set, I love equally being in the studio. And I never meant to get
so out of my mind with you playing cool. While Nicole may be his greatest duet partner, this new album, his 10th studio release, is full of them. The standout, a most unlikely collaborator for the boy from Queensland, pop superstar, Pink.
We had this song called One Too Many, which is it's a duet. And I just had her voice in the back of my mind. I'd met her briefly at an award show, but really didn't know her. But through a friend of a friend, managed to get the song to her. Luckily, she loved it. And next thing I know, she's on this song. It's crazy.
Was she allowed to come to you, or did you do it on Zoom?
No, she recorded. She's out in California, so she recorded at her place. And then we shot a video, which was equally...
How do you do that?
Complicated.
Nashville, California. How's that?
Yeah. Well, I was here by the time we were shooting the video.
And do you pick up the phone at the end of it and go, well, thanks, Pink.
It's amazing.
It's Keith. I mean, it was great.
No, I sent her a piano, actually.
As you do.
As you do, with a big bow around it.
Keith Urban says he never chose this life. It was just a case of picking up a guitar at 6 and never looking back. It's been a wild ride. But living in uncertainty, as we all are, he holds on to the joy of live performance and the vivid memory of going to a Johnny Cash concert when he was 5 years old. It's that which brought Keith here and gives him hope for the future.
That'll stay with you, that concert, you know. When you're 5, that kind of crowd, they were just smashed, just paralytic. They've showed up hammered, you know, rowdy and hardworking. It's just like, rah, you know, 5 years old, just going, what is this world? This is fantastic, you know, more of this. And then this guy walks out on stage, and then, like, he says something, and they scream, and then, boom, this hush came over the place. You could hear a pin drop.
And do you get that you're that bloke now? You're Johnny Cash on the stage, and we're the ones in the audience with the light and the noise, and we're waiting for you.
It's so strange. I promise you, I don't feel that much different to when I moved to Nashville 27 years ago. I don't feel that much different. I feel as giddy and excited about playing guitar, getting in and recording a song, making a record, writing a song, getting out on the road, putting a tour together. I feel exactly the same. It's crazy.
Hello, I'm Liam Bartlett. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9Now app for full episodes and other exclusive 60 Minutes content.